Well, hi, everybody. Welcome to Southern Miss Sports Today with Coach Jay Hopson, presented by Bancorp South. Golden Eagles, a tough weekend. Last weekend out in San Antonio against the Roadrunners of UTSA. They'll try to bounce back this weekend on a trip down to Baton Rouge to take on the LSU Tigers. And Hop, let's talk first about the weekend. And I guess pretty easy to see. I mean, that one right off the bat. Not a quick start for the Golden Eagles. The Roadrunners took advantage of that and built an early 21-0 lead.
Yeah, it was down 21-0 right after we got off the bus, it felt like. You know, just got in the hole early. Certainly didn't, you know, play our best game. Again, that first touchdown I thought was a little bit of a pick, but that's neither here nor there. And then they got a big play, and then a couple big plays back-to-back. And we fought hard for 60 minutes. We did. We just dug ourselves too big a hole, and just one of those games is just tough to swallow.
You can't get rid of big plays after they've happened, but if you do take two or three of those big plays that they had in the ball game, different ball game.
It is, and it starts out, you know, again, it's one of those losses that's frustrating. Like I told the kids, I mean, heck, you can put that one all on me. You know what I'm saying? At the end of the day, we gotta come out and execute and do things better.
All said and done, though, you're down at halftime, but you get the ball to start the second half, put together a pretty impressive drive, have to kick a field goal. So you had a chance there early in that third quarter to get right back in it.
Well, we kind of had a couple little phases there, John. In the second quarter at 28-14, we had the ball and a chance to kind of make it a one-score game, which kind of changes the complexion a little bit. And then coming out of the second half, I thought we were going to go down there and score and get it to a 10-point game and with a lot of football left. And certainly weren't able to get in the end zone, had the field goal, and then gave up another big play or two. And certainly just one of those days it just seems like nothing goes right.
Even late in the ball game, you're able to, you're down, I think, 16 or so, and you're driving down. Looks like maybe going to make it an 8-point ball game.
Right. And we had about 4 minutes to go, and we were talking, you know, if we score here, go for two, it's down to an 8-point game. And we had enough time on the clock to still kick, because we had three timeouts left, to kick it deep and play. Had a turnover, and then we got it back, used our timeouts, thinking, okay, if we can score, get an onside kick, but then we gave another big play, and something we can't do.
Yeah, a few positives in the ball game. Offensively, you did some good things offensively to try to battle back in the ball game. Got a D.J. Thompson, some big catch of the ball game. Chase Whitehead makes his first start, makes some big catches. So some guys that showed up pretty good there on Saturday.
Yeah, our receivers executed pretty well. You know, we had a few drops early, which are critical. That's things we can't have, especially on third down. But I thought they ran good routes, and I thought they played hard.
All right, it was the Golden Eagles and the Roadrunners of UTSA on Saturday in the Alamo Dome in San Antonio, Texas. Let's go back and take a look at all the action from Saturday, the Golden Eagles and the Roadrunners.
Mullins, play action fake. Nick's looking to throw over the middle, got up. Catch by Corey Robertson. He almost lost it. Now he breaks away. Then he fumbles it and picks up on a bounce and goes down into UTSA territory. Staggers in motion from right to left. Mullins dropping to throw. Looks and throws down the field. Got a man caught by Corey Robertson. He breaks away. He's trying to get to the first down marker, and he will, down near the 26. Smith, the deep man, plants and fake. Mullins going to throw in the end zone. Wide open, Jay Sean Washington. Touchdown, Southern Miss. They fool him. They fake the run, and Jay Sean Washington is there in the end zone, wide open to make the touchdown catch. And Southern Miss gets on the board. Maybe offsides against UTSA. Mullins down the center of the field. And Staggers reaches back and makes a catch. Staggers reaches back, makes a catch, going down at the 28 with a man hanging on him.
Yeah, that was unbelievable right there.
Flap snaps his hands, takes a snap, throws over the middle, a slant caught by Jones, cuts in at the five, and dives down to near the one-yard line. That's the best throw of the day by Nick Mullins as Jones came on the slant from the left side. C.J. Levine saved the touchdown. Eagles now at the one-yard line. They convert on fourth down. Mullins with Smith, handoff Ito, right tackle, trying to get in, and did he get in? No signal yet. Hit, touchdown Southern Miss. Ito Smith on the one-yard run after the big fourth down catch. Sturm will work out of the shotgun with a back along his right side. Takes a snap, being chased by the Golden Eagles. Got away from Ruff, but that's it. Eagles going to sack him. Back inside the 35, around the 33-yard line. Leading the charge that time was Ruff, and I think Ruff may have been able to recover and make the tackle. Bradley was there as well. And in motion now is staggers. Mullins looking to throw over the middle. Corey Robertson makes a catch across the 35 and out to near the 42. Had to reach back, but he did. Staggers in motion right to left. Eagles handed off up the middle. Ito broke one tackle, broke another. Heads around the right side. Ito to the 50, and they run him out of bounds, but he's into Roadrunner territory. Triangle formation left side. Mullins, plash and fake. Looks and throws. Right sidelines and caught by the Eagles. And that is a touchdown Southern Miss, or is it? DJ Thompson made the catch, and it is a touchdown Southern Miss. Nick Mullins laid that one out perfectly where only DJ could get it, and he was able to hang on. Touchdown Southern Miss. And it'll be Williams who dances and got hit. Danced and got hit by Sherrod Ruff. Sturm takes a snap to Williams. Got hit in the backfield and dropped for a loss by the Golden Eagles. That was Ladarius Harris who made first contact for the Golden Eagles. And going to throw it over there. Got a wide open Staggers. Makes a catch on the slant and goes down at the 46 of UTSA. Mullins takes a snap, has some time, down over the middle, and Whitehead makes the first down catch, takes it inside the 30, stays on his feet, but his knee was down, back at the 28. There's the snap back, and the kick is up, and the kick is good. Schoenfield now 10 for 10 in the field goal department this year. Staggers in motion and going to hand it to Staggers. Had to change direction. Gets a block around the left corner. He's in loose at the 30, the 25, the 20, and runs out of bounds inside the 15. Brings the fullback in motion. Play action fakes and got knocked down loose, but stayed on the scene. Then he got hit from behind and dropped inside the 5. He got hit, but bounced Michael away. And then Curtis Michael was able to finish things off. So the Eagles put him in a second down and long. Inside handoff and a good stop there for no gain. Maybe actually a loss on the play as they hand it off. Sturm going to hand it off, and the Eagles almost get a safety. Boy, they hit right there around the goal line, and Dylan Bradley leading the charge. And that's a loss of about a yard, maybe a yard and a half. Claps his hands and going to leave it with a second man through. Ito, who spins away, stays on his feet, breaks a tackle, then caught from behind and brought down at the 26. He was an ankle tackle away from a touchdown. Now look at the throw. Mullins over the middle. That one caught by Whitehead for a first down. Mullins drops the throw, looking and fires over the middle. Got a man caught by Whitehead, and Whitehead's going to score a touchdown. Touchdown Southern Miss. Well, Nick got enough on that one to get it to Whitehead out in front of the defender. Able to bring Allen in motion from left to right. They're going to throw it into the end zone. And did Mullen get it to him? Yep, Allen caught it for a two-pointer. And the Roadrunners of UTSA have defeated the Golden Eagles 55-32.
You're watching Southern Miss Sports Today with Jay Hopson. Brought to you by Bancorp South, right where you are. Coca-Cola, taste the feeling. The City of Hattiesburg, a proud sponsor of Southern Miss Athletics. UPS, visit ups.com/solvers to find out more.
And once again, back on Southern Miss Sports Today with Coach Jay Hopson, presented by Bancorp South. Well, as you know, each week we have a feature on one of the senior members of this Golden Eagle football team. And today, Hop, it's on D'Nerius Antoine, a young man who came to the Golden Eagles out of the junior college ranks last year, had a really good season a year ago, and he's picked up right where he left off last year here in 2016.
Yeah, D'Nerius is a young man that plays hard. He's a guy that certainly has made a ton of plays here. He's a competitor and a guy that's extremely talented and got a bright future ahead.
And he's a guy that could play and does play a lot of different types of positions for the Golden. He can go back there and be the old-fashioned defensive back. He can come up and play almost like a linebacker, so a guy that's and a versatile guy on the special teams as well.
He is. He's very talented. And Eddie can long snap too. You know, he can catch punts, long snap. You know, he's a competitor. Certainly, I thought he, you know, had a great game last week with a lot of tackles, and just a guy that makes plays for us and a guy that we need to make plays.
And he's a guy that sort of fits into that nasty bunch defense. He's a guy that probably could have played in any era of the nasty bunch the way he plays the game.
No question. Physical and just, you know, loves the physicality of the game. That's one thing I love, is the fact that he loves the contact and certainly a physical football player.
How valuable is he, or what makes him so valuable to not only the defense, but to this football team?
Well, Nettie is one of those guys, like I said, that he plays hard. A couple of those, you know, he had a couple saving tackles. Those are things I always look at as a coach. You know, one breaks, who's chasing hard, who's digging hard, who's giving. He had a couple of really nice plays, and plays people don't really realize, even the Kentucky game. He made it a great effort tackle game there early that allowed them not to score. We hold them, get the ball back, and it was a play that's the difference in the ball game. That's one thing he does. He plays with great effort every Saturday.
Yeah, no question. This is a guy who loves to play the game of football. We had a lot of fun sitting down and visiting with him recently as we talked to him about his career and about Golden Eagle football. So let's spend a few minutes and visit with Golden Eagle senior D'Nerius Antoine.
Armstrong, play action fake, slant over the middle to Westerkamp, tipped and intercepted by the Eagles. Antoine's got it. Antoine, right side, takes it inside the 10.
I enjoy playing the game of football, I would say. I mean, hitting. I like to tackle. I mean, I like to cover. I mean, but just being able to do it with your brothers, whatever, or whatnot. So, I mean, being that everybody together and all in for the same mission, it helped and bring excitement. My uncle was always there and helping guide me down the right direction. I mean, he kept me in sports. I started with baseball, then basketball, then football, and I'm here now. Coming out of high school, I only had football offers. But when I got to JUCO at Trinity Valley, my freshman year, I actually played basketball. But I lost the love for the game and wanted to focus on football. I feel that the difference between last year and this year would be, I mean, I got my experience. So I feel like it's not going to be a walk in the park, but it'll be a learning process. I would to learn from my mistakes last year and better than this year. Prepping for game, I mean, it's a lot of hard work. Watching film, I mean, it's not just watching the good and the bad or the touchdowns. You got to, like, watch the techniques of certain players. Offensive linemen, wide receivers, the splits, and this, I mean, yeah, I could be outside the hash, inside the hash. stuff like that. And I mean, when you study that down and you see it when come Saturday, you already know what to do.
Caught for no gain by D'Nerius Antoine.
This year, I mean, it's gonna be real exciting because I mean, we bought back a lot of starters, a lot of people that played, got a lot of playing time, and I mean, like we all coming together. I'm not saying like last year we was together, but this year, like we spend more time together, we do a lot of extra stuff together and stuff like that. And that's gonna really help us and benefit us when we step out on the field Saturday. As a backup plan, if football don't work, I would like to go into coaching. I'm majoring in sports management, and if it's either coaching or being a sports agent, one of those two.
It's another at the 20, 15, gets a block, cuts back in, touchdowns. His body got a foot down for a Golden Eagle touchdown. Mike goes up. Short of slant, Trent Taylor, but he's going to be brought down for a loss.
Sophie, his 13th birthday. Gift? We've got you. Guitar? Coming tomorrow. Road game today? Surprise party tomorrow. Change of plans. Game tomorrow.
No, birthday tomorrow.
Hotel. Guitar? Reroute.
Birthdays are on birthdays.
Party? Relocate. UPS My Choice makes rerouting packages easy. Mom! How we're helping companies solve for the needs of customers like Sophie.
Well, you know, my job is to take care of people, first and foremost. When it comes to the health and safety of athletes, you know, there's a lot of things that goes into play with that. It's not just taping ankles, and it's not just giving them water on a daily basis. There's a lot of things that we have to pay attention to and to make sure that these kids get the quality of medical care that they deserve. When it comes to the physical that we do at the beginning of the year, you know, now we're looking at things like sickle cell. We're doing baseline testing on the brain so that we can evaluate concussions better. We're doing strength tests on different parts of the body with different athletes so that we can try to identify weaknesses and, you know, try to overcome those to prevent injuries from occurring. So, you know, I mean, we kind of wear a lot of hats with what we do on a daily basis that I think a lot of people don't really pay attention to a lot of times. We enjoy being behind the scenes, I'll tell you that. Well, I think, you know, back in, you know, the old days, going back to the pre-Doc Arrington days, you know, what was an athletic trainer at that time? They wore a lot of hats, but, you know, at the end of the day, you know, I think if you look at what they did back then versus what we do now, there's so much more of a developmental approach with these athletes and these people that we take care of. You know, I guess back in the early days, it was more of, you know, get them water, get them taped, you know, keep them alive on the field. And nowadays, it's all of those, but now we're working them out. We're trying to develop their bodies as we develop their, you know, situation from the injury perspective. And, you know, hopefully the product that we're putting back out on the field is you know, a much more encompassing body than what we had, you know, what they used to deal with in the past. Well, you know, when I was in school, they had two different routes to get your certification from. You could do an internship route, or you could go to an accredited curriculum, excuse me, you know, kind of like a nursing degree program. Nowadays, as allied healthcare professionals, we are, you know, you can only get your degree in athletic training and sports medicine from an accredited program. And, you know, the one thing that's unique about this place, Jim Gillespie and Doc Arrington really set the bar. You know, when they created the curriculum here back in the late 80s and early 90s. This is actually probably the cornerstone curriculum for the whole entire Southeast. I know the athletic training curriculum at Alabama that I came from was modeled after this curriculum here. Well, you know, what I always tell all of our recruits is you know, we really have one mission. If you're going to bring someone in here to represent your university, especially on the athletic stage, then they deserve to have the highest quality of medical care while they're here. And, you know, with the relationships that we've got with all of our physicians, you know, and all the board certifications that our physicians have, you know, I really believe that the selling point is that we have a rich community here with, you know, multiple physicians. Our, I guess you can say our medical team here, which consists of 40 plus different physicians from different specialties, are really accessible with a backdoor policy at our beck and call, which really makes this place special. And, you know, we're gonna make sure that we meet that mission. We're gonna make sure that these kids have the highest quality physician to take care of them. And we're gonna make sure they get seen in a quality amount of time. And then the communication between me and my staff and the parents also goes a long way with making sure these kids are taken care of effectively too.
The only game I ever saw until I suited up and played in one myself. The only game, I was 14 years old, and I sort of told a little bit of the story at the induction, but my dad had asked me and my older brother Scott if we wanted to go see a Saints game. Well, we were like, yeah, sure. I mean, I was tickled pink. We lived close to New Orleans, but we never went over there. Come to find out, the reason he took us was to get us out of the house so my mom could set up a surprise birthday party for Scott, which, you know, who cares? And that game was important because had the Saints won, they would have gone to the playoffs for the first time in history. And as you know, the Saints did not have much success before or after for quite a long time. So it was electric. And so sitting, and they were playing the Rams. I'll never forget Mike Lansford. You know, I remember that night as if it were yesterday. Mike Lansford, barefoot kicker, ended up kicking a field goal at the end of the game to beat the Saints and kick them out of what would be their first playoff appearance. But I remember sitting in the seats before and just thinking, man, this is really cool and big. You know, I'd driven by the Superdome many a times, but never gone in. And all of a sudden the crowd goes crazy. And it was, and I look, what's going on? And it turns out it was Kenny Stabler coming out of the tunnel. And I thought, you know, that's pretty cool. I'd love to be that guy.
And once again, back on Southern Miss Sports Today with Coach Jay Hopson, presented by Bank Corp South. We'll talk about this week's opponent, LSU, in just a couple of minutes. But Hop, we saw a feature a few minutes ago with Todd McCall and athletic training, the sports medicine part of things with Golden Eagle football. And, you know, they've always been valuable, back even the days with Doc Harrington and Jim Gillespie and those guys. But those certified athletic trainers and the students that are part of that program are really, really valuable to what you try to do.
Just they're invaluable. They do a tremendous job. You know, Todd's the best in the business. You know, there's nobody that I would rather have as my athletic trainer. And he's one of those guys that runs a tight ship. He's a guy that also does his best to always get those guys healthy back on the field and just does a tremendous job.
You and your coaching staff put in hour after hour after hour during the week of preparation for a game. But if you're down in that training room, Todd is there, it seems like 24 hours a day.
That's right. It takes pride in his work. And again, we can sit here. I kind of feel like Nick Mullins. I can sit here for 2 hours and tell you good things about Todd McCall. But Todd does a tremendous job, and we're certainly blessed that he's our trainer.
I always ask you, we talked about this before, about the academic side of things and that communication that's got to take place. But I would think that relationship, that communication between you and Todd is very important. He's got to let you know what's going on with your players, and you've got to kind of know what's going on with them.
There's no question about it. And you know, you got to have that great communication during the week and also on game day. That's always critical when one guy's out and you got to make a special teams adjustment or an offense or defensive adjustment. So again, Todd does such a great job with all that stuff, and just like I said, we're just blessed that he's a Golden Eagle.
All right, let's turn our attention now to this week's opponent for the Golden Eagles. That'll be the Tigers of LSU down at Tiger Stadium in Baton Rouge. First of all, you spent a year there, didn't you? I guess 1994 with Curly Holman, so you sort of know what it's like to be there in Tiger Stadium.
Well, it's a great place, and you know, and I've certainly played there many times too with different programs. But you know, the bottom line is we know we have an outstanding football team. We got to prepare for, and certainly they have our utmost respect. They're a football team that barely lost early to Wisconsin. Had a, you know, that Auburn game was one of those controversial game deals. So they're a team that very easily could be undefeated or ranked in the top two or three in the country. And so we know we have an outstanding football team on our schedule, and we know we got to be ready.
They've had, of course, the coaching change, but it's been the last week's been kind of crazy for them. They were looking forward to playing Florida down in Gainesville last week. Of course, the hurricane forced the postponement of that game. So I bet they're going to be chomping at the bit to get back out on the
football field. Well, it's football. If you're a competitor, that's the reality. You love to get back out there and play. I mean, I think – you know, both sides are going to be excited, ready to play football. That's just the reality of football. But again, they're a football program that has our utmost respect. You know, Coach Ogeron has come in, that staff, they've done a great job, had a big win against Missouri, 42-7. So, you know, we know we got a good football team. We got to play on Saturday.
What do they do offensively? What's their style? What do they want to do?
Again, they're a physical football team, and they're a football team that lines up in three or four different personnel groupings. You know, they'll get into 21, 12, 11, mix it up, some 10, 22. So they're a team that, you know, basically has every run in the book and do a great job off play action, and you know, just a well-balanced football team, a team that makes you prepare hard.
Hop, we appreciate it. Thanks, as always, for the weekly visit. And we'll see you down in Baton Rouge and see if the Golden Eagles can't figure out a way to win that one.
Appreciate it, Coxie.
All right, Coach Jay Hopson of the Golden Eagles down at Tiger Stadium in Baton Rouge to take on the LSU Tigers. That's a 6:30 kickoff time down in Baton Rouge. Glad to have you with us there, and glad for having you with us here each week as we talk Golden Eagle football with Coach Jay Hopson. Don't forget, Monday nights we're at Georgia Blue for the Golden Eagle Hotline. Come on out and visit with us. Join us, and we'll talk a little Golden Eagle football. That'll do it. Have a great week, everybody. See you next time. Another inside look into Southern Miss football.